Not long ago, Charge Lab released a video about the Charge product launch event, which included the Internet Hoskit power bank. It is co-branded with the movie Wandering Earth 2, and recently we got one and gonna take it apart to see its internal structure. First, let's take a look at the box. The Wandering Earth 2 and Charge logo are with the corners. The power bank itself is printed in the middle of the box. Flip to the back, some specs info are on the back, we'll get to that later. Open the box, there are some documents. Now let's take the power bank out. It is very similar to the prompt in the movie. We can see there are three buttons and a display on the front. It also comes with an independent USB-C cable. Pressing the button can light up the display. It can show the output, input power, and battery capacity. These three buttons are used to control the display. Click the generate button and it will keep generating random passwords, just like in the movie. Click the confirm button and the process will stop. To the left side, there is a black USB-A port. And the USB-C cable is stored in this independent storage slot. It's soft and easy to bend, and the USB-C connector adopts a full pin design. Move to the right side, there is a black USB-C port with a rubber plug for dustproof. The specs info are printed at the bottom, same as what's printed on the box. Model is SP040A. Its battery capacity is 10,000 mAh, 36.5 Wh. First, both USB-C ports can fast charge it at 20 watts. As for single output, both USB-C can reach 20 watts, and the USB-A only supports 18 watts. When charging two devices at the same time, the peak power can be around 40 watts. But the peak power won't exceed 35 watts when charging three devices. The size of it is about 28x54x29mm. It has a slender body and looks pretty cool. ChargeLab Power ZKM003C shows the USB-C cable can support SFCP, PD3.0, PPS, QC4, DCP charging protocols. And it has three fixed pedals of 5V, 3A, 9V, 2A, 12V, 1.67A, and 2 sets of PPS. The USB-C one supports FCP, AFC, QC2.0, SFCP, PD3.0, PPS, QC4+, DCP charging protocols. It has three fixed pedals and two sets of PPS, the same as the cable. And the USB-A supports FCP, AFC, DCP charging protocols. After testing, let's try to take it apart. Use a spudger to pry along the gap and remove the covers of the buttons and display. Next, we will use a small cutting machine to separate the USB-C end. Remove the protective cover of the USB-C port. We found a circle of potting compound inside to fix it. The back cover is fixed with clips and glue. There is a battery pack composed of four battery cells, which are connected to the PCBA through wires. Let's remove those fixing screws. Continue to separate the battery pack and PCBA, and remove all the hidden screws. Let's take out the PCBA and cut off all the wires that are connected to the battery pack and USB-C cable. Those battery cells are fixed with poly paper and tape. They were connected in parallel to form the battery pack. The solder joints are insulated with heat-shrinkable tubing. The 18650 battery is from Lixian. Ready voltage is 3.7 volts, and the capacity of a single cell is 2600 mAh. The PCBA module is stripe-shaped. The display is fixed by a plastic frame and connected to PCBA through the flat cable in the middle. and its backlight panel is connected to the PCBA with red and black wires. There are two independent circuits on the left and right. The MCU is on the left, and the display driver is on the right. Battery gauge IC, LDO regulator, and battery protection chip are on the back. These two battery protection MOSFETs are connected in parallel, marked with 2556. The 1mΩ sampling resistor is used to detect the battery pack current. The mass control chip of the USB-C circuit is from iSmartWear. It's highly integrated and supports multiple fast charging protocols like BBS, PD, QC, etc. It can also support two independent circuits and multiple USB boards, dedicated to power banks. The 2.2 microhenry alloy inductor is reinforced with porting compound. The MCU is marked with NAXIM and NXW003F. The mass control chip for the other circuit is also from iSmartWear with the same model, and the corresponding 2.2 microhenry alloy inductor next to it. The Titan Micro driver can drive the circuit of a 32x4 LCD display. The regulator is from Micro, marked with 4AWD. These two VBUS MOSFETs are used to switch the USB-A and USB-C cable outputs. The Selwish battery gauge IC can be used on the system or battery pack and supports high current. It integrates a high-precision ADC that can be used for voltage, current, and temperature measurement. The LDO regulator is marked with 8327A. Then those three SMD buttons are on the front of this tiny PCB, which are connected to the main PCB through wires. Flip to the back, the back body paper is used for insulation. Well, that will be all the components of this power bank. After taking it apart, it has two independent circuits with two master control chips. So both USB-C can support 20 watts, and the total power can be up to 40 watts. The battery pack and internal solder joints are reinforced and insulated, making it solid and more durable. Extra USB-C cable allows you to go out without carrying any cables. So if you're a fan or need a unique power bank, you may consider it. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!